Hello, friends. Welcome into NFL Daily, presented by BetDSI, the internet's number one sportsbook. I am your host, Tom Downey, here now with the NFC cap cuts. One for each team. We're talking notable players. They're going to save a lot of money, not the random guy you've never heard of that gets cut before the season really gets underway. So we'll start things off over in the NFC East with the Dallas Cowboys. And it pains me dearly to say it, because I am a big Sean Lee fan, but it really doesn't make sense to keep him on the roster anymore. Highly intelligent, has a career as a coach as soon as his career is over, but he carries an over $10 million cap hit into 2019, and the Cowboys can save $7 million by cutting Sean Lee. You can get a backup who will give you the 20 snaps a game that Lee's going to play at most next year for the Cowboys for far less than $7 million. So just from a pure money perspective, it makes too much sense to not keep Sean Lee. He had time for him to go, even though I hate to say it out loud. The answer is C, it's time for him to be cut. Save the $7 million, don't burn the bridge, and then once it's over, have him come be the assistant linebackers coach and eventually work his way up to wherever his career takes him. On now to the New York Giants. Now, edge rusher is still a big need for them, in part because Olivier Vernon hasn't been the guy the Giants need him to be. Has a $19.5 million cap hit. They can save 11.5 if they cut him. 15th, well, it's after June 1st, meaning it kind of a bookmaking type thing for the NFL. You split the dead money across 2 years if it's after June 1st. Either way, it's a lot of money for the Giants to save for a guy that battled injury and had 7 sacks last year. So for Vernon, chance he comes back. It's not set in stone like maybe a Sean Lee or other guys we'll get to later on are. But I think the monetary savings has it making sense for the Giants to cut Vernon. Folks, today's show is brought to you by BetDSI. It's the internet's number one sportsbook. Head over to chatsports.com/bet. Use promo code LIVE120 for a 120% deposit bonus. Then, once you sign up and deposit with MasterCard or Bitcoin, DM us on Twitter, @chatsports, and we'll get you guys hooked up with an NFL jersey. It's the best deal out there, but it gets better. If you use Bitcoin, that 120% deposit bonus becomes 150%. Now, if you have trouble with Bitcoin, we understand. DM us. We'll help you guys out on Twitter, @chatsports. Just the best deal out there if you guys are trying to bet on sports. Next up, Timmy Jernigan. $13 million cap hit. The surprise answer, the guy has the fourth highest cap hit on the Eagles roster. If he's cut, the Eagles save $7 million. Now, there is a timeliness factor here for the Eagles and Jernigan. His $11 million base salary this year fully guarantees on March 16th. So after that point, they can't cut him. They don't save any money. So a decision will have to be made here before March 16th. Battled injury this year. Maybe there's a restructure or a pay cut of some type to get him to come back, because I know Philadelphia likes him. But at that contract, he's not going to return. Now, I mentioned that not every player on this list is a lock to be cut. One of those guys who is a big question mark is Josh Norman. Now, $14.5 million cap hit. The cap savings are $8.5 million, $11.5 million if it's after June 1st. And the Redskins have a tough decision here because he hasn't really been locked down, number one elite cornerback, top five Panthers guy, Josh Norman. But he's still been the best cornerback on the Redskins roster, because they really don't have that many good quarterbacks right now. So Norman, the Redskins have a tough decision there, and I think in the end it might come down to this. Can we find a cornerback for $8.5 million? Can we draft one and spend that money elsewhere that makes our team better? I don't know what the answer is there. So what should the Redskins do with Josh Norman? As of right now, I lean more towards keeping him, but there is enough reason and discussion to at least for the Redskins to consider cutting him instead. All right, let's recap the NFC's cap cut. Sean Lee, I think he's gone. Timmy Jernigan, I think he's gone too. Both those guys will not be back at their current cap hits. Olivier Vernon, Josh Norman, a little bit tougher decisions to make for those teams. We'll move now to Dion Sims of the Chicago Bears. And we mentioned Vernon and Norman being easy cuts. Dion Sims is an easy, no-brainer decision. He's got a 6.33 repeating cap hit, $6 million of which can be saved, and the dude didn't catch a pass after week one. You have Trey Burton, you have Adam Shaheen, you don't need to pay your third-string tight end $6 million. Just cut him, move on, use the cap space to go extend somebody or re-sign someone in free agency. Move now to the Detroit Lions, and I didn't really have a great option for them. I went with Nevin Lawson, but like some other teams we'll discuss, really not that many notable or obvious cap cut options. Lawson has not been that good as he was in 2016, a $5.25 million cap hit. You can save $4.125 at that point. I think you just move on from Nevin Lawson, go draft a cornerback in the early rounds. But if he comes back, I'm not going to be all that upset either. Folks, subscribe to us on YouTube if you haven't already. If you haven't, I don't really know what you're doing. YouTube.com/ChatSportsTV. Get us to 100K subscribers. We are working our way steadily toward that. Have all kinds of great coverage for you this offseason. Plenty of draft. All the free agency you could possibly want. It's the number one NFL channel. YouTube.com/ChatSportsTV. Green Bay Packers now. Jimmy Graham, and I was wrong. I really like the signing for the Packers and Jimmy Graham, but it did not work out. As a $12.67 million cap hit, it needs to be done before June 1st, by the way. There's some extra incentives coming on. There's a $5 million roster bonus due for Jimmy Graham on March 15th. If they cut him, it saves $5.33. This is not the Saints Jimmy Graham that we all knew and loved. 55 grabs, 636 through the air in terms of yards, and two touchdowns. That's not going to get the job done for Green Bay. Let him go. You got two first-round picks. Maybe draft a Noah Fant or an Irv Smith or a TJ Hockenson in what is a loaded tight end draft class this season. To the Minnesota Vikings we go. Mike Remmers, and I kind of waffled on this one. There are some other guys I considered here too, but for Remmers, a $6.35 million cap hit. You can save over $4.5, $5.75 if it's after June 1st. And the Vikings need to upgrade on the offensive line. And although Remmers is maybe not the biggest problem, I don't think he's the solution either. Money's tight right now for Minnesota. They can use that elsewhere and find the guard in the draft potentially. Some other names to watch out for. Andrew Sendejo, maybe not the most notable name, saves like $5 million. And your dark horse, by the way, which I did not put on here but strongly considered it, Kyle Rudolph, non-guaranteed $7.6 million cap hit. He could be cut. Maybe Minnesota drafts a tight end early in round one or round two. Let's recap the NFC North cap cuts. Dion Sims, that's a no-brainer. Nevin Lawson, maybe. Jimmy Graham, maybe the Packers give him one more year. And Mike Remmers, Minnesota just needs to clear some money and get some more offensive line help going forward. Kicking out to the NFC South. And we'll lead things off with Vic Beasley, who I know he had that great 2016 year. He has not been that dude since then. If you paid attention closely, you knew that those sack numbers might not be repeatable, that they were a little bit fluky. There were some not as many hurries, pressures. He was a prime regression candidate, and that's checked out. Since that 15.5 sack season, Vic Beasley has 10 sacks, 5 in 2017, 5 in 2018. I don't think you want to pay over $12 million for 5 sacks a year. That's just not good value there. Now, it's a non-guaranteed fifth-year option, so you could see Atlanta try to restructure his deal, extend him, or maybe they just cut him and then try to re-sign him. But Vic Beasley, he's not been the guy Atlanta had thought they were going to get after that elite 2016 season. The Carolina Panthers, and I'll make note, Torrey Smith I think is going to get cut because that'll save $5 million on the cap for the Panthers. It's a non-guaranteed salary. But I need to talk about Matt Kalil. And if you've paid attention to me, if you've paid attention to Chat Sports for years now, I despised the Matt Kalil signing from the start. It never made sense. He was bad in Minnesota, and Carolina just threw money at him. Now he carries a $12.15 million cap hit, and he didn't even play last year because of injuries. Now, the way the deal is structured, they can only move on from him after June 1st. That would save $7.25 million, because you're going to split the dead money across 2 years. Otherwise, you end up eating 2.55. That's not good right there. It might end up being the case, regardless of what happens, that because the Panthers paid Matt Kalil, they ended up losing Darrell Williams in free agency. Now, what is your least favorite free agent signing of all time? Let me know in the comments section. It's not Matt Kalil for me. Do you guys remember when Dwayne Bowe signed with the Browns? And they got like nothing out of him. That's my probably all their least favorite signing of all time because they got so little production for so much money on a deal that just made zero sense. All right, back to the NFC South. The New Orleans Saints. Cam Meredith carries a 6.45, almost 4.6 cap hit in 2019. His season, really his entire career, has been limited by injuries. The Saints save $3.7 million if they cut Cam Meredith. They could also cut Kirk Coleman. And if they want to have any chance of keeping Teddy Bridgewater, they're going to probably have to cut those guys, possibly some others, and some restructures as well. I did not include Andres Pete, who does have a non-guaranteed $9-plus million deal. But I think an extension to get the cap hit down makes more sense for the Saints because he's still playing fairly well, as far as I'm concerned, for New Orleans. Today's show was brought to you by BetDSI, the internet's number one sportsbook. Head over to chatsports.com/bet. Use promo code LIVE120 for a 120% deposit bonus. And after you sign up and deposit with MasterCard or Bitcoin, well, go DM us on Twitter at chatsports, and we'll get you guys hooked up with an NFL jersey, official one from Nike. Best deal out there. And by the way, the deal gets better, because if you use Bitcoin, it becomes a 150% deposit bonus. So use that extra money there. Put down 100 and use Bitcoin. Instead of getting 120, you get 150. If you have some issues or questions on Bitcoin, we'll take care of you. DM us on Twitter, at ChatSports, and we'll get you guys set up. We'll move now to the NFC South for one last team. That is the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Gerald McCoy, I feel like his time is up. And I don't necessarily agree with it, but McCoy has hinted that he thinks he's probably done in Tampa. GM Jason Licht was kind of open and like, yeah, we got some tough decisions to make there. McCoy's contract, which will count $13 million against the cap, is non-guaranteed. There's no more dead money left. There's no more signing bonus left there. There's none of that. If he's cut, the Packers, or the Bucs have no dead money, and they save $13 million in cap space. Now, if McCoy is the open market, there will be interest. I think he can still play at a high level. So where will Gerald McCoy play in 2019? Let me know in the comments section. I think there are a couple of different options that could make some sense. There are plenty of teams need some defensive tackle help. And frankly, the list of teams that want Gerald McCoy will be far longer than the list of teams that don't want him. Let's recap those AFC South then. Or cap cuts, excuse me. Vic Beasley, Matt Kalil, bad contract. Cam Meredith and Gerald McCoy, who I still like a lot, but it does save $13 million against the cap. Let's take you now to another contract that I never liked when it was signed. That is Jermaine Gresham of the Arizona Cardinals. He has simply not produced enough for Arizona. A $7.22 million cap hit, and because it was a bad contract, they still only save $2.47 if they cut him. Becomes $4.2 if it's after June 1st. But this guy mostly plays on rundowns. He is a glorified blocking tight end right now for Arizona. That's making $7 million next year. You blew it, Arizona. Bad signing from the beginning. Ricky Seals-Jones is outplaying Jermaine Gresham, and even he's not all that good. Imagine paying a guy $7 million next year who caught 9 passes for 94 yards the previous season. And yeah, there were some injuries, but he still played enough to get a lot more than 9, basically one catch a game. That's unacceptable for Jermaine Gresham at his contract. Guys, I am wearing a Mizzen and Main shirt. You should get one too, because they make me look passable on air. Go check them out, comfortable.af. It's the best damn dress shirt out there. Incredibly comfortable, and they're made right here in America. Three teams left in the NFC West. Next up, the Rams and Mark Barron. Now, a lot of different defensive options here. Maybe Michael Brockers if you want to try and re-sign Sue. Marcus Peters, Aqib Talib. No dead money. They can save a lot by cutting one or both of those guys. But I'll go with Mark Barron, who I just don't think is all that good. He's kind of, I think, a bit miscast in the Rams' defensive scheme. He has an $8.9 million cap hit. Didn't really make all that many impact plays. He just doesn't quite have it for the Rams anymore. Cutting him saves $6.9 million, $7.9 if you wait till after June 1st. Save that money. You need it, because if you're the Rams, you went all in this year. Now you got to say goodbye to some players going forward. Good news for the Rams is they did make it to the Super Bowl at the very least. The San Francisco 49ers, and they're also in pretty good cap space right now. Not a lot of bad contracts right now, 46 plus in terms of projected cap space this coming season. But Eric Armstead might just be the odd man out. A $9 million cap, thanks to the fifth-year option on his rookie contract, which is non-guaranteed, so you cut him, you save all of it. Here's the big issue, though, for Armstead. He hasn't been a sack machine, just three this year. The Niners need to develop Solomon Thomas, or at least try to. He was the number three overall pick not that long ago. And he's younger than Eric Armstead, and they're a little bit too similar. Both those guys, I think, are best as the kind of base defensive end kicks inside to play DT on third down. You already have DeForest Buckner in the three technique. That's one guy in that type of role. You can't have three of them on the field at the same time. It can only be two. So pick one, Solomon Thomas or Eric Armstead. For me, it's a no-brainer. Give me Solomon Thomas on passing downs, which is very common in the NFL. Kick him inside. Let him have success. All right, last up here, folks, it's the Seattle Seahawks. And I didn't really have a great option here. I went with Jaron Brown, but Seattle, for the first time in quite some time, not a lot of obvious cap cuts there. About $55 million in cap space. Jaron Brown only caught 14 passes. Yeah, five of them went for touchdowns, but you can save $2.75 million by cutting him. Maybe you get David Moore more reps. Maybe you draft somebody else too. Maybe Amaro Dagba finally emerges an actual option for the Seattle Seahawks. Either way, I think you move on from Jaron Brown if you have to. But for Seattle, not that many obvious cap cuts. Let's recap the NFC West. Again, one from each team. Jermaine Gresham, Mark Barron, Eric Armstead. You got to get Solomon Thomas more snaps. And then Jaron Brown. And in the end, the NFC West, maybe not the sexiest names on that list. Guys, if you have not already, subscribe to us on YouTube, youtube.com/chatsportsTV. We just went through the NFC cap cuts. The AFC cap cuts are also up on there. So hit that button, youtube.com/chatsportsTV.